Hey there, it's Brendan. Creating a drop-down menu in Shopify is simple and easy. Today I'm going to show you how to create one so we can take a messy menu like this and turn it into something that's nice and neat like this. Let's go ahead and jump right in and take a look. All right, so here we are in our demo store, and we can see our main menu across the top. There's just too many options here. It's too messy and confusing. We want to make it simple for people to get where we want them to go on our website. So let's go ahead and create some drop downs of some items so that they're nested and it shows a lot neater. So we have this shop button here. I think it would be great if women's, men's, and kids showed below the shop button. So let me show you how to do that. We'll go into our Shopify admin. Along the left-hand side, click online store. Then below that, you'll click navigation, and you'll see the menus that we have available. Let's go ahead and click on the main menu since that's the one we're working with. So we can see here's the shop option, women's, men's, and kids. But we want these three to be nested or show below shop as a drop-down menu option. So what we'll do is you see these six dots next to women, go ahead and click and you'll see a blue line appears with a circle along the left-hand side. If you pull it in, the blue circle shifts in. When you release, women's is now nested below shop. So let's do the same with the men's and the kids menu options. We'll click on men's, we'll pull it in, release, same with kids. And we now have three options below shop, women's, men's, and kids. Let's take a look at what that looks like. Let's go ahead and click on save. Then we'll come here to our online store and we'll click on the I button. And you'll notice our main menu has changed a bit. We don't have the men's, women's, and kids option anymore, but we do have a drop-down arrow by shop. If we click on that, we'll see we now have our three options nested below shop. But let's say we want to take this even further and we want to clean up this main menu even more. And let's say we want to show kids' t-shirts below kids, women's t-shirt below women's, and men's t-shirt below men's. Let me show you how to do that. So we'll go back to our menu option. And we'll do the same thing with the grab and drag. So kids' t-shirt is going to come up here to kids. But instead of having that blue circle below shop, we're going to pull it in even further and it'll now be nested below kids. So let's go ahead and do that with women's. We'll bring it up, we'll pull it in, and women's t-shirts, men's t-shirts, same thing. And we now have a double nested or a double drop-down option within our menu. Let's take a look at how that looks on our front end. Go ahead and click save. Then we'll go ahead and click our I icon next to online store. And you'll see our top menu is even cleaner now. It's much simpler for people to determine where they want to go. And if we click this drop down menu here, we can see if that shopper is looking for women's items, they can hit that drop down and get directly to women's t-shirts. Now we don't have these other ones set up in the demo store, but maybe you had women's shorts or women's hats. They could all be nested below women's, allowing people to get quickly where they want to go. Now there's one last, I guess, bonus tip I want to give you that's unrelated to drop down menus, but it deals with menus in general, and that's this home button. Almost everyone who's shopping online knows that the main logo image will take you home. So this is an unnecessary main menu item. Let's go back into the admin and we'll see our home here. Let's go ahead and delete that. Remove, save, and let's look at what our main menu looks like now. There it is, two menu options. In the most ideal situation, you should have no more than 3 to 5 main menu options for your store. So by using the drop-down menu, we're able to get people to quickly get where they need to go via a nice, clean drop-down menu. Guys, that's it. It's real simple on creating a drop-down menu. It really helps with the user experience. It helps clean up your main menu across the top, and it will help you increase sales and conversions on your website. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll see you in the next one.